Hey everyone, let's talk about how to define variables in Google Sheets. Being able to store variables can save you tons of time and help you enter longer equations much quicker. Let's just get right into this. Let's say that we want to store a variable for the number of cheesecakes that we have sold on a given day. And due to wild price fluctuations in cream cheese, we want to calculate our profit cheesecakes sold for the day. So let's just click up here in the cell A2, where we have our number of cheesecakes sold in a given day. Then we can come up here to the top left and alter the reference name to this cell. Then let's call this CC sold and then click enter. Likewise, let's do the same thing for the price of the cheesecake on a given day. So let's call that CC price. Now, anytime we want to call that variable, all we need to do is refer to our new variable name. So we could say CC sold times CC price, and this is going to be our total revenue we earned from selling our cheesecakes on that day. But what other cool things can we do with this kind of information? Well, let's say that we had two cheesecake shops. Let's add another row and call it CC2 sold. For our second cheesecake shop. Now, as you can see, we could just add the sales of our two cheesecake shops, and that will be the total number of cheesecakes sold. We could also add another variable that combines the total of our two cheesecake shop sales into a single value. So let's just add another variable that simply adds cakes sold from store 1 plus cakes sold from store 2. As you can see here, Google Sheets will autofill all of our available variables to us that we have created. Then, in another cell here, we can multiply the CC total times the CC price, and we can see that the revenue earned from all of our cheesecake shops together. Then, by altering the cheesecake price or number of cheesecakes sold, we can see that it changes, which is pretty cool. Now, obviously, we have been working with some pretty simple formulas here. However, this technique of naming cells as variables is incredibly helpful with more complicated formulas, as it allows you to enter formulas much easier, particularly long formulas. Additionally, what if you don't want to see all the information on your main Google Sheets page? Well, let's just create another page here and call it Revenues. Now, we can call our defined variables in this new page without the need to have the information actually present in this page. Therefore, we can simply hide our previous page if we want to, and still easily access the information through calling the names that we defined previously. Thank you for checking out this video on defining variables in Google Sheets, and I hope it helped your understanding. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking the join button down below, or our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.